please put your paws together and join me in welcoming the rest of Rubber Legs. So we are Rubber Legs. We're gonna do some improv for you. We need to get started as a word.
Robot.
Oh no.
You broke it again.
No. You said that it was made of better stuff this time.
Made of iron, sir. I assure you, she can sink.
What are you... I'm not blaming you, but what are you doing to it? You break it all the time.
I'm a kid. I climb trees. I run. Run around the beach with no water shoes on. Climb rocks, tree stumps, fences. I opened manhole covers. One time there was a light down there, like a lamp. It wasn't even like a sewer. I didn't know they had like offices down there. And there was like a ladder set up. It was like a little white room. I climbed a tall ladder. I climbed a short ladder. I locked myself out. I climbed through the bathroom window. I danced in the shower. I come down the stairs in just sock feet. One time I brought a glass. A swimming pool. I drove from the deck and I forgot when I got out and stepped on it. My feet were wet and soft and wrinkly from swimming.
Some sort of agreement. Like, your clearly adventuring lifestyle needs to tone down a little bit. Maybe not both the short ladder and the tall ladder. Maybe just the short ladder.
But what's the point of buying a little giant if you can't make it a big ladder? What are the selling points?
I know. At the very least, maybe you don't walk around in sock feet so much, or try to move a chair with your broken elbow. Like, you've got other parts of you that you can move a chair with. You don't have to focus, like, so much on the broken part.
All right, I'll try something new.
You're still focusing on that, on that whole broken arm. You are right-handed, but are you? Because you really mess up a lot.
Wait, handedness.
know where to start.
I thought it was the arm you hurt the most. It's that arm that obviously gets the most use. That's now your dominant hand.
See, the order of those is all off. You can be, you can use your right hand for most things, but that doesn't mean you have to break it most often. No, don't.
Well, I'm not sitting in the chair.
Well, you don't have to put pressure on your right arm as you go down. You got another arm. You can use it once in a while. This hurts me. What did you do to that one?
I didn't want to tell you about that one. They're both
broken. How'd you break that one?
Sometimes I play marbles.
But you look like you want to dance. Me? No, I'm an accountant. Yeah, I just started at Bat Bowler and Bagley. my office. No, it's not on the. I don't have an office on the top floor. It's kind of a basement. Yeah. Well, my office is in the sewer below the building. Yeah, we're the only accountant firm down there. We realize that nobody owns that, so we can just put new employees down there rent-free. So that's why we're so good at accounting. What? No.
So in 1975, I published my third novel. And this book was called The Boy Who Broke Everything. Now, it wasn't a huge hit because people said it was too scary to read. They opened it and they screamed and they put it back on the shelf. Ah, that book is long out of print now. They could never publish it again. Everybody who tried to print it dropped dead of fright. The scariest book ever written. Fuck you, R.L. Stein.
Suddenly you're in your attic, you get a whole nest up there. You know what I mean? That's the thing. So you're going to want to seal this all off, definitely. You know? Or see if the current owners will do that before you take it off the price. You know? But I'll tell you, in a neighborhood like this, I bet I'm all those kids. Those kids look like climbers. They're going to climb up in there. They're going to nest in there, and then you can't get them out.
What? Did you just say they're showing a house? Just shut up. They're showing it.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not kidding. They're showing the house.
Ooh, walk-in closet. Tick. Yeah, you can see this is where they keep their milk cold behind the waterfall. That's always a sign of kids' festation, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They used to come with the railroad tracks. That brings them into town.
Okay.
These kids always come in on the railroad track. They're like box cars, they're all over the place. Do you got any unsolved mysteries in this town? You know what I mean? That's where they come
from.
We
do.
There's some of them will get into mystery solving, but they always live somewhere.
The case of the old car. The case of the disappearance.
This is our goddamn house!
Oh my God.
I am not going back to that train!
I've never felt
felt like I had roots before, you guys. I like having roots.
Is this hardwood?
Yes, it's hardwood, you freaking idiot!
I noticed that you snapped your bindle stick, and I applaud you.
Yep. Yep. I got had enough.
Tech. So you can see it on the fence post. This marking says there's food here. This one says there's hot pie. This one says free sticks in the back. That's how the kids know it's friendly for the other kids to come by. They come in, they mark the fence. You're going to want to paint this whole fence, maybe rip it out, because that's carvable fence, and the kids will get in there with their knives.
Well, I'm a first-time homebuyer, so...
Well, you got to look for these things.
I don't think I'm going to buy this house.
I wouldn't.
God, this is the longest showing ever. I need a hot pie.
They're just kind of standing around with their arms crossed now.
They got free bindle sticks now? Oh my God!
Should we boxcar rush them?
So in 1983, I published the last of the Railway Boys books. And it was the case of the bored realtor. That was the last one ever published. People said it was too mysterious, and they got lost in their own minds.
Watch you work.
He's still here?
Yeah, but this time he said it's a pleasure to watch me work.
Sir, could you leave our house?
Seems to me that if a door is unlocked, you're just inviting company in.
So. I don't want to call the police on them. It seems rude, but...
Brought my own milk this time. Some chocolate.
He's following the house rules.
It's pretty good.
Oh yeah, shoes are off.
Appreciate that. I didn't use the recycle bin. I appreciate that.
You could have worn pants, though.
Right, but here's the thing. I finished trimming the hedges.
I hope that's not a euphemism.
Not a euphemism. You can tell it's not a euphemism.
Sir, ma'am, got rid of that hedge trimmer, so... No need to worry about him coming back. So, just want to let you know that it is a pleasure to watch.
I was just about to say it was a pleasure to watch you.
You guys have been here for 3 days.
Doing our job, sir.
It seems rude to tell them to leave.
What are we thinking?
I brought the extra pack of toilet paper, so...
You're welcome.
Do you guys want some ravioli? Is it meat-filled or cheese-filled?
Cheese-filled.
This guy doesn't speak to this guy, I'll tell you right now. Cheese ravioli me. Our shoes are still on. House rules! We learned about the house rules in the first 2 days! There we go. That's a sorry.
It did land in the ravioli, so...
It's my shoe.
It's okay.
Ravioli cheese shoe me.
Yeah, we'll fit right in with the taste.
This seat's not taken, I guess.
Upgrade.
This is the 8th time this week I've had to make ravioli.
realize how much toe hair I have. Oh yeah. Have you noticed that before?
I mean, I.
Why is it my responsibility?
I feel like it, I've seen it so much that it just kind of blends into the background.
Yeah, I see the problem here. I'm glad you brought these back to Birkenstock, sir. You see, the problem is that your toe hair is just too dense for the sandals to actually go on your foot.
You're saying it's lustrous?
Oh, yeah, this is incredible hair, sir. I'm having a hard time not running my fingers through it. It's sort of like, have you ever seen deer in the wild?
Yeah.
And you kind of just want to, you know its fur is going to, like, when you touch it, but you still kind of.
Wait, what's the fur gonna do? Yeah, I seem to recall that.
It thinks you're a fly, that's why.
Really?
Yeah, but sir, anyway, you're not gonna be able to get into the brush box. Not with that much foot hair.
Yeah. There we go. We call that the Rachel.
Jesus, could you guys just leave?
Megan, take a seat.
For the record, I did right away when you said
it. Yeah, I'm surprised and I'm shocked and I know that you're trying to pull one over on me. Make that pull two over on me because I know you didn't read that book.
What makes you say that? Look at this spine, it's all bent.
Oh, the spine?
It's all bent. Look at all that.
You made a whole report and everything. There's a staple through all the pages.
Look at all these dog-eared pages. Oh. I've read it and stopped and reread it multiple times.
I know. Oh, my goodness. I know you didn't read it.
I didn't. You're right. I didn't. I experienced it. Some would say I journeyed with it. You know, it was part of me for a while. It was. I don't think reading isn't enough of a term. I would say, I don't think reading's strong enough of a descriptor from what I did with the book.
I've been your teacher for the past 3 years.
Too long, some would say.
Oh, yes. Some would say way too long.
What class is this? What class is this?
It's part of a new learning program where they want the teacher to grow with the students, and it friggin' sucks.
It's too long.
I know it's not your work. I know it.
How? I can't.
3 years. 3 years I've been
this
dealing
is,
with
I've
you.
Turned a new leaf.
Oh, no.
Leaf.
You've not turned a new leaf.
Look at this. Come on. This is.
But it's the same leaf.
No
it's just changing colors.
This is all. Look at this. Look. I spilled coffee over here. Was reading it.
Yeah, I know. And it's the same blend of coffee that you bring in on Thursday mornings.
It's my Thursday morning coffee. Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. We analyzed the sample. This is pretty expensive, but yeah, we determined the coffee stain from the page you sent us does match Cafe Escape's coffee.
I knew it!
Sir, let me ask again, how are you paying for this extremely expensive and undoubtedly very important test?
I maxed out all of my credit cards, and don't worry about the payment. You're going to get paid. It's me that's fucked over for the rest of my life.
Hello, this is Chase Credit. How may I help you?
Oh, hey. So if I get a...
Do you have a question about your account, sir?
I just, how many cards can I open at once with you? And if I open up a card at Amazon.com, is that
okay.
Also okay?
Just bring up your balance here. Okay. You do have a card with us already, and I'm seeing you've got $5,000.
Yeah, that was a speakerphone.
You've got it. Pardon?
Oh, I bought a $5,000 speakerphone. That's why I've had my hand up to my face this whole time.
Well, congratulations, sir. I can't even tell that your hand is near your face this whole time. You're speaking so clearly.
Yeah, it's not near my face.
I understand.
That's
the
beauty
of
a speakerphone. But onto the credit cards. I need another one.
Oh, you know, well, you have $20,000 on this. this one at a limit on this one card.
Okay. Can you double it?
What do you want? Do you want me to?
What?
There's not much I do here at that point. I look up.
Can you double my credit limit?
No. No, that's... No.
All right, then. You can take my debt, and I'm going to leave this whole...
Wait, excuse me, sir. Can I ask, is it for another...
Sir, just hold on one second. Yes, we'll be doubling your credit rate shortly. Roz, I've overheard that customer was asking you to double his credit limit, and you said no.
He opened with how many cards can I open with you? I feel like that's a red flag. What is he doing with multiple cards from one credit card carrier?
Sir, hold on
one
second.
That doesn't even make sense.
When you say double, we're going to triple, right? Aren't you happy? You're very pleased. Yes, please fill out the survey at the end of this call.
I'm just saying we can't just have one have multiple credit cards in one credit card company.
He's clearly crazy.
What is he doing with multiple cards? What is he going to do? Funnel all separate cards to one testing facility to give him one test? Does it make sense? Spread it out over five cards? What is he calling in multiple credit card numbers? That doesn't make sense.
I'm not getting this right yet. Roz!
What?
You're getting too involved.
I'm worried about it. Multiple credit cards. Well, who even calls a credit card company for multiple credit cards in one facility? Wouldn't you try to get multiple places?
Remember your training.
Roz, I've been calling all day and I finally got you.
Okay.
Are you excited for this update?
Okay. I mean, I'm listening, yeah.
We did a forensic reading on the dog ears of each and every page. They were folded at different forces. It couldn't have possibly been done by the same hand.
No, you can't do that.
Somebody else read the book. She didn't read the book, Roz.
I can't give you another credit card, bud.
Roz.
I can't give you another credit card. I've got to cut you off on the credit card.
No, Roz.
I can't do it.
Roz. Sir, hold on one second. I said hold on. He's so close.
Quiet.
He is so close.
I think he's clearly glowing. He's going through something.
You care about him.
Something's going on.
You care about
he's
him.
He's obsessed with this. It's not healthy. I worry about him. I worry about that young girl. Why has he been her teacher for so long? What's going on there? What kind of school system is that? Does it make sense?
You're never going to run out.
This lines up.
You're never going to run out of questions. Just cut him off. Give him the extra credit, and then stop right there.
Hey, Roz.
What's going on?
Roz.
You can't keep calling her like this.
We're so close.
You gotta stop.
She's graduating next month.
But there's a lot of people you're wasting a lot of time. There's a whole row of us.
But I'm gonna get her. She's not gonna walk across that stage, Roz.
Maybe she just read the book. Did you think maybe she just read the book?
She didn't read the book, Roz. She didn't do it.
Maybe she read the book.
She didn't.
Maybe for once she read. Maybe she turned to me.
Roz. Roz. Roz.
What? What's going on?
You look into your phone right now, and you tell me that you don't think that she read that book.
I'm wearing a headset.
So that's, they told me that you can't make a financial thriller that's also a young adult.
No! That did not happen!
But I said, fuck you, John Grisham. I can do whatever I want.
Oh, I hate that guy. I hope he does fuck himself.
Oh, hello. You've been watching my documentary. I'm Craig the writer.
I've known Craig since high school.
Yes. He didn't help me do anything. He's just here for moral support. Now,
Barry, what was Craig like in high school?
Oh, we have an audience for this. I was just filming a documentary.
I've got a PA.
Okay. So, I got. So when I wrote that meta scene about myself.
Well, sorry, I'm late! You switched rooms on me! Come on, man!
So I was telling
you were such a dick in high high school. I'll tell you that much.
Oh, I was just telling the camera there about the time I wrote a documentary.
Snore, yawn, other sleeping expressions.
Pause. So when I directed this film based on my own life, what I was thinking was, what kind of person would write a meta scene about his own documentary? And then it hit me. Me. That's why I wrote it, you see? Anyway, thank you so much for watching this documentary about me, Craig the Writer.
I'm going down this only open road I've ever known, you know? That's the thing, is, you know, like a twister, I was born to walk alone. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I'm getting out here. That's what I'm saying. Didn't mean to make it so dramatic, but
no, it's fine. It's fine. You know, wake me up.
What, before I go?
No.
Or like
when you know, when September ends.
I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker.
You go get that gnage.
Ooh, motoring, huh? Motoring!
Yeah. That's my Christian sister.
How's she doing?
Good.
Yeah.
Hair's coming back, which is nice.
The Vanga bus is coming. Everybody's running.
It's one of the neighborhood kids.
I'm a joker. I'm a smoker. I'm a midnight toker.
I didn't see him leave.
No, he just circles around. Could you just pour some sugar on me, please?
Sure.
Is this in the name of love?
I'm a joker, I'm a smoker.
Did we always used to talk like this? What?
Yeah.
Just saying, like, sorry, it's just like a weird thing. Like, ever since we had those Wi-Fi chips implanted in our brains last month, we've just been, I feel like our conversations have been, I don't know. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight soaker.
What's going on?
What?
I'm just gonna be environment.
This is just how big they are.
they are.
Wow.
A toddler mutant.
Because it's not mutant yet. It's just ninja.
When I wrote this extremely meta-impressed.